Before I get into the subject of my talk, is given this title, I have a confession. How many people in here grow carnivorous plants? Okay, that was an easy one. I just bought my first one last night. How many people here have a hybrid in your collection? Nearly the same number. I'm not a horticulturalist, and I've got black some brown probably, but I go to the plants, and I love to find out what they're doing. Probably not alone in this room for wondering what's up with all this hybridization and what's going on in nature. And that's the focus of my work. Each species, believe it or not, is doing the same thing. There are three, actually four pulses of flowering. So here's Gracilis. First pulse, a double pulse, and then the last pulse. It stops flowering. And Frazier and Ambularia have this whole time to themselves. On the other hand, in the very beginning of the flowering period, Gracilis has a pulse all to itself. Other than that, because their pulses are offset from each other, it's hard, you can't predict when or in what frequency species will be in flower. Sometimes Gracilis flowers and Ambularia and Frazier have 80% overlap in their flower period. Gracilis Ambularia, which will make trichocarpa, at least 45% of Gracilis region. And the question is, ultimately, do these lead to differences in the visitors, the pollinator species? Nepenthes Gracilis has very small flowers. These are the males. They tend to have maroon sepals that are recurved. I think it's an ant guard, actually, to help prevent small ants from getting out of the bar. It's cup-shaped tepals, or sepals, and a very bright ovary. The stigma's here black, again, as I just said, that's not indicative. These are all old. And in earlier inflorescence on that first night, the stigma is bright green. Also, it's the only published report on pollination in Nepenthes was done on Nepenthes gracilis by Cato in 93. And he found levels way up here in Sumatra. And I copied that, but other insects like bees love thick nectar because they need to have a high sugar. So it makes a big difference. I didn't find a difference between species, but I found a significant difference across species between Malaysia and Singapore. The Malaysian species are making the same approximate percentage of reasons what came with this high, they're called hexose, it's glucose and fructose, nectar is correlated with fly pollination. As far as I've been able to find, I don't know why they have different tastes in their sugars. And let's get on to who's doing the work here. This is Nepenthes Frazier R, and it is pollinated by moths. This is a moth of a female. It's a fairly large moth. But you also have small moths doing the pollination. Here's as much small as a, what do they call it? It's a parala, a snout nose moth. Again, as I said, see look, here's that difference. The first night that anther column's white, and then this next. Here's another moth. This is on the Nepenthes Ambularia. And you can see them sweating the nectar on their sepals. It actually, it's not cupped, but it has a groove down the middle that channels the nectar when it accumulates into the area between the sepals. Very different from the Nepenthes Ambularia. Wasps are also pollinators. Here's a large wasp on the Nepenthes Ambularia male. Here's a wasp pollinating. I should say, I know these are pollinators because, first of all, I have observations of them going from male to female plants, and second of all, I have observations of collecting them, of pollen on the wasps. And here he is doing the duty for a female Nepenthes gracilis. Again, some of these wasps are very beautiful. Flies, as expected, based on the morphology and the nectar characteristics, are pollinators of the Nepenthes Ambularia exclusively. Well, not exclusively, I should say, but the other kind. They're in the same general group of what I call Carnivorous minors, ship flies, things that are attracted to nasty, smelly butterflies. regular visitor to Nepenthes ample area, not the other species. And it's one species that I saw, and I saw it on several different sites, both in Singapore and Malaysia. So if anybody knows who this is, glad to know. So let's look at a summary of differences in the pollinators. In fact, each of the three parent species is using a significantly different suite of pollinators. There's overlap in the individual types of pollinators, but the proportions are staying pollinated primarily by small things, the small diptera, but also it may act as a barrier signal using moths that the small size of one species puts the pollen in one place, and like the Phaeton humerus and Trichocarpa, Cupriana, or Rosemary, is compared to the same species. Low insect capture rates, maybe Cupriana, but again, all three hybrid types seem to be doing something.